It was after 3 years, the Bible declared to Robert, God sent an evil spirit between Abimelech and Shechem house. So they started destroying themselves and fight her, and Abimelech was killed. Why do I say that? We pray a lot of prayer, which I'm not going to go into that. You can see this one in Judges chapter 9. If you don't go to Judges chapter 9, you will see the whole story. So also, this is not just a new story. It has happened before, and it's still happening. If you are very conversant with the story of Joseph, it was just the same thing. The brother of Joseph, their mind was to keep Joseph. Thank God for the grace upon the life of Joseph. And he was not together, he was sold out to go and die. He was sold out to go and meet whatever he would meet. But thank God at the end of the day, because Joseph was a man of God, a child of God, he obeyed God to the end, and God in the foreign land raised him up to become a prime minister. So you are also left out. Wherever you have run from Africa, you run from wherever, God will also make you a prime minister in your own city in the name of Jesus Christ. What am I trying to bring here now? Because these are people that are evil. Evil people are everywhere. They are in Africa. They are in Nigeria. They are in Uganda. They are in Poland. They are in Cameroon. They are in Greece. They are in America. In fact, they are everywhere. And if you are not careful, those people that you think that they are very close to you, they may be the one that is destroying you. That's why you need to be very, very careful. That's why the place we read in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15 to 18, be careful how you walk. Be careful those people that are harassing you. Be careful people you are going to visit. Be careful who you are walking with. Because the days are evil. You cannot know anybody except the Spirit of God tells you who that person is. That's why the Bible says, by their fruits we shall know. Amen. Praise the Lord. So having said that, then we are, and the Spirit of the Lord will ask me to go further. So now today I'm going to let us know so that you can know the characteristics of evil people. Amen. You may not know evil people. Let me tell you. The devil is so clever. Subtle. Clever means you will not even know they are like green snake inside green grass. I happen to see some snakes. Some snakes, their color blend with the color of their surrounding. I don't know if you have some of them. There are some that are brown. You don't know, they don't blend with the color of the soil. You don't know. But as you match them, pow, at once, it strikes you. Not that you really want to mind them, but you don't know. They just cleverly. And there are some animals like that too. Amen. I was watching the crocodile, one big buffalo was drinking water in a pond. And the crocodile saw it from afar. He just came back inside the water. I was swimming. But little did he know the buffalo was going that something was coming. So he blended with the water. But the time the buffalo knew was, rah! Try his leg. The Lord helped us to say, that's how the enemy are. They set trap that you don't know yourself. Except God will be on your side. Except God helps you, you will fall into that trap. Today, the enemy is our big enemy. They set trap for you as a child of God, as a pastor, as a deacon, as coordinator, as a husband, as a wife. They set trap waiting for you to fall. And when they fall, you say, after you say you be Christian. That is what they want to prove that you are not. God help you if you have the Spirit of God and you know them on time. Amen. 419, you will not know that somebody is a 419 until you have already cleared your account. They come with suits. They come with corporate dressing. They speak English. They do whatever they want to do. You will so believe them that, this business contract you are going to take. No, do it then that, you will be hammered. That we should do good to every man, especially those in the house of God. Because Galatians chapter 4, 15 to 17. That is good. That's what we're talking about. So if somebody is trying to hide away, that the person, if I take, that those when I was doing, when we were doing panegyric, I told one of my neighbors, where is it happening? He said, he didn't want to tell me. I said, why are you hiding it? He said, well, see now, and then he said, somebody's taking me there. So it depends, I'm taking it there, you don't want him to pick up that person. I said, okay, no problem. So that time, I just carried my car. So the way I do it that day, that time, I just traveled. Where am I going? To this Lamia side or whatever. So I said, I'll be going from one place to another, one place to another, one place to another. That's how I got to know every of this family by myself. So on this occasion, he said he was not going, that he's going somewhere. At the end of the day, the place I went, that's where I met him. I asked him, now hear the wrong wish. No, see now. You think I'm going to go here? May the Lord help us. When somebody is trying to deprive you from getting breakthrough, it's an evil person. That's what I want. I don't tell him, is a brother in the church? No. Devil will be inside the church too. Because Jesus Christ was having a demon possessed person among the 12 that sold him. So if there will be dead demonic person, bad people, evil person among the 12, then it will also be Judas among us. Are you the Judas today? Don't raise up and say, no, I am not. That was to answer your conscience. So what am I trying to say? Whenever you see a brother and a sister, anybody, and you can be able to help that person, you refuse to help that person, you are evil. You understand it? Is it difficult to understand now?
No.
That's number one. Number two, they will not tell you the truth. The Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall do what? Because they don't want you to be free, they will not tell you the truth. There are pastors today that they don't tell people the truth. They don't want you to know the means of their power. They want you to be come to them and I thank God for God in this way. If you grow up and become like me, I'm so happy. Hello? If I cannot do this, so I want us to share ourselves. A good father will want his children to grow more than him. And a good mother too. So why would I hide this from you? The only way that sometimes when I stand here, I say, I have tested God. I have no God in this area. God is good. God is nice. God is wonderful. God is faithful. Why God? I have tested it. And I'm telling you the truth. If you remain permanently obeying God, if you remain serving God faithfully, God is too faithful to fail you. Yes, that's the truth. So I tell you the truth. Amen. The truth that you can be able to use to run the whole house, to run the whole life, to run the whole children. It would be wicked of me to tell you what is not. And hiding things from you that will bless you. May God help us to just say. So today, people, they hide the truth from people. And when you see that somebody is hiding it from you,